Well, hi guys, I'm Scott. It's been a while, hasn't it? Well, I'm up here in the Smoky Mountains today, and here's the sign. We're at the Trillium Gap Trail, taking it to Grotto Falls. Then we'll be going down the Brushy Mountain Trail to hit the Porter's Creek Trail, camping out at Campsite 31. Tomorrow, we'll get up and head back down the Porter's Creek Trail over to the Grapeyard Vine Trail or something like that. And we'll camp out at 32. Then we'll hike back out to the car the next morning. So y'all stick around. My friend Jerry's coming along with me. So we got a few creek crossings to do. This isn't even the falls yet. It's been raining a lot, so the trail's slick and muddy. It's a pretty steep climb up to Grotto Falls, so I'm already sweating and had to shed some clothes already.
Uphill!
And we have reached Grotto Falls. What do you think about it, Jerry?
Uphill!
The trail goes right underneath the falls. That's pretty wild right there. That is cool. Now that is worth the climb to come up and see. Check that out. There comes Jerry. That's cool.
It's uphill!
What's that?
It's uphill!
It's uphill. I forgot about the llamas that come up through here, and they make a mess. We've got snow up here. We're climbing up elevation too, though. We're at, I think, around 4,200 feet right now. It's real pretty. There's Brushy Mountain, 0.2 miles. Oh, it's only 0.2 miles. I thought it was 0.4. So, well, that'll cut us a little slack there. And then we'll be going to the Porter's Creek Trail on 4.5 miles. It's mostly downhill, I think, though. So we're gonna go look at the top of the mountain here. This trail isn't very popular, it don't look like. It looks more like just a ditch that you're walking up. I'm guessing it fills up with water when it's raining. And it's pretty steep. All the brushes. I wonder if that's why they call it Brushy Mountain. Well, we're not at the end of this trail yet, but there's a little pull-off right here for this view. I am thankful for this view. That is just beautiful. We've reached the end of the trail. It just dead ends to a bunch of brushes. But let me see if I can extend you up. I don't know what the view looks like up there. You're up a lot higher than I am. Another stream crossing. Oh wow, That's a drop if you fall there. Ooh, that's slick too, ain't it? We are going downhill on the Brushy Mountain Trail. And there's snow, a little bit slick, but it's pretty. Which way are we going, Jerry?
Downhill!
We got a creek crossing here on the Brushy Mountain Trail. a little bit of a waterfall there. That's pretty cool. All right, guys, we made it to the Porter's Creek trailhead. There is the sign, Brushy Mountain Trail. We just came off of it. Now we've got to go down here and we've got to find the trail we need to take. I think it's to the right up here. Nice little area right here. I don't see the sign. Alrighty, here's our sign. Got 2.7 miles to our campsite. Well, I'm sweating to death again. We got to climb up to 1,500 feet, but here's the bridge crossing. Whoa. I want to step off. Got a little stream crossing, but it's been raining, so we've got a waterfall here on Porter's Creek Trail. Pretty neat. Of course, being here in person looks a lot better. So many trails up here, I don't know which ones I've done, apparently. I've already been at this campsite before, so I just did 2.7 miles on a trail that I've already done before. Oh well, I'll get to mark it off this time. I don't have my tarp down yet, but I replaced my straps with the tree huggers with some mule tape so that it'd be a little bit lighter weight. Got me a new down 20 degree under quilt from Hang Tight. We'll get to test that out tonight and see how that works out. Jerry's set up with a thermarest, and all we gotta do now is put the tarp down, get a fire going, get some water. We can eat, enjoy the rest of the night. So we'll probably just see y'all in the morning. Well, morning, guys. We made it through the night. It's cold this morning. It's in the 30s. I don't know what kind of 30s, but it's in the 30s. We're gonna get some coffee going. But anyway, we're gonna do this, get camp broke down, and get back on trail. Jerry is boiling some water. He's got one of these gourmet coffee presses. So we're gonna check it out and see how he makes his coffee with the press.
Coffee in the press. Man. 2. Had a little loaf.
And then we wait for the water.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Next we add the water. Then we wait.
How long do you wait?
About 5 minutes.
Oh, you wait about 5 minutes?
About
just let it sit
minutes.
There?
Yep.
Oh, so it's sitting there steeping?
Yep.
Okay.
All
right. Voila. You take the lid back off and just press it down? Look at that. Look at that.
You're supposed to drink out of that little hole. It'll burn you. Drink out of a cup instead. Good stuff.
It's good. Good stuff. Had this for a while. It's gourmet coffee press in a to-go cup. Do you remember where you got this, Jerry?
Walmart.
Walmart? I didn't know.
They quit selling them because they burn your lips so bad. Nobody ever. Probably got in trouble.
I'm sure you could find something like this on Amazon, though. All right, guys, before I break down my hammock, I was wanting to give you a report on this underquilt. It was, I got it on Etsy.com, company called Hang Tight. It's supposed to be a 20 degree underquilt, and it was only $115, which is a very good price for that. But it got down to, I'm guessing, around 32 last night, and I was comfortable. So I'm guessing it'd probably get down to around 20 and still be fine. So I enjoyed it. Again, that was on Etsy.com. If I remember, I'll put a link to it in the description below. Alright guys, we are back on the trail and we're heading to campsite 32. We got to go down this Porter's Creek trail, which is mostly all downhill. And then we've got to go up past Greenbrier Campground, that little road that goes up to it, and hop on the Grapeyard. I think it's Grapeyard Ridge Trail. I'll have to look at that and let you know. We'll show you the sign when we get there. This section of Porter's Creek Trail from the trailhead we took up to the campsite is just a gravel road. So we're taking it up to the road, and then we've got to walk up the road a little bit to jump on the next trail. We are here at the trailhead of Grapeyard Ridge Trail. So we got 3.2 miles to the campsite, 7.6 miles all the way to the road, which we'll be hiking to in the morning, which will be 4.4 miles out to the road, then 1.2 miles back down to the car on the road. So let's get started and get to camp, and then we'll eat lunch when we get to camp since we're this close. This Grapeyard Ridge Trail has several streams crossings that are unbridged. Luckily, this one had a log here. I should have got us going over it because I was sketchy going over it, and thought Jerry was going to fall off there for a minute, but I didn't record it, so y'all missed it. There's the train in the creek at the Grapeyard Ridge Trail. Pretty cool. All right, guys, we are here at campsite 32. It's a pretty nice campsite. There's the bare cables, fire pit. Somebody's already gathered some wood up for us. All right, we're gonna eat some lunch. I've got some turkey spam, some tuna, some mashed potatoes for tonight. I'll just kind of mix it up, meat, lunch, and dinner together. Eat a little bit now and a little bit later. We got camp set up. Here's Jerry's castaway hammock and my Noah 9 tarp. And we got him pulled up in there. That way if it starts raining, it's supposed to start raining in the morning. Early, well, actually about 11 o'clock tonight. So got him kind of raised up there. That way he can stay dry.
Dry is good.
And then we got mine down here. There are plenty of spots for hammocks here at this campsite. This is campsite 32. I like this campsite a whole lot better than the one we were at last night. So I've got this new tarp, which I don't know if I'm very fond of it or not. I don't even remember what the name of it is, but I've got it set up. I've got 11-foot hammock, and it comes right here at the edge, so I tried to kind of pull it up as high as I could and put me up kind of high to keep me dry, and I think I'll be fine. Say Jerry is pretty good at building a fire. Well, I started it.
Yeah, it was all team effort.
Jerry got it going this good though.
Well, good morning guys. It rained last night. The wind blew real hard. It's still blowing kind of hard. This whole flap right here would come blowing in. See how it's blowing out right now? It would come blowing in all the way up against my hammock. Stayed dry though. I don't know about Jerry yet. We'll check on him in a few minutes. But I'm trying to kind of lay here. See how that's blowing right now? The wind blew like that all night after around 2 or 3 in the morning. Blew real hard. The rain wasn't too bad. I hope Jerry stayed dry. We'll go check on him. But anyway, I'm trying to get stuff packed up a little bit so we can start heading out of here. So we'll check on Jerry in just a minute.
Hey, Jerry! Did you stay dry?
I'm dry.
That wind was horrible last night, wasn't it? Look at there, it's still blowing pretty hard.
Food bag, stay dry.
Did you have that tarp hanging up, the blue Walmart tarp?
Yeah, it didn't last.
Oh, it didn't?
About 2:30 a.m. it went whap, 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 gone.
Did it blow away or?
Oh, I rolled it up.
Oh, wow. Those grommets are not worth it on that.
No,
We're talking about those little blue tarps that you can get at Walmart. Apparently, the grommets are no good at all. We had ripped one out yesterday and put a quarter in there to make a grommet out of it. Did you save the quarter?
I do not know.
Well, it was about $8 then. Well, anyway, we're going to try to get packed up. It should quit raining here in about 30 minutes or so. I think it's already quit now. It's coming and going, so we'll get packed up and get ready to get out of here. We'll eat some breakfast right fast, and we'll see you out on the trail. Yeah, he's got him a hiking bike. Check it out. He bought him a hiking bike, sleeping bag. That's a, what degree is that, 20? 15 degree sleeping bag. How much was it? Like $130 or somewhere around there?
$130, $150.
Yeah, $150, $130, somewhere around there. They're very well worth it though.
Good bag. Good
bag. I love mine. My finger has a hole in it. Like right in here. And it was this poop trowel right here. It folds in and out. And while I was scraping off a log, this little section here went all the way down into it, into my finger. It popped out and closed back up on me real fast. So I don't recommend these shovels at all. And you see them all over Amazon. I about pinch my finger again. We'll leave this thing alone before I get hurt. We'll see y'all later. Well, we're getting back on trail here and we're walking out of the campsite, but we've got to go to Roaring Fork Road in 4.4 miles. I got 500 foot climb right now, so I'm not going to be filming because I can't talk while I'm walking uphill.
Downhill!
Jerry, we got a stream crossing.
Downhill!
How are we going to get across this one? Very carefully. All right, those rocks were kind of loose, so I'm putting this thing up. Roaring Fork Road, 1.1 mile.
Yay!
These hills are pretty hard to climb up through here. And you're gonna have them either way you come on this trail. Roaring Fork Road, 0.1 mile, so there's the road right out there. You probably can't tell it in this camera, but we're right here at the road. Here's the old settlers, I guess, farm place here. This is at the very beginning of the Grapevine Ridge Trail, which you use this road right here to get in. Well, I just thought we were done. This mile back seems to be a road walk, but it's all uphill. We cheated though. We threw our packs back and hid them back there because I've got to drive down this way anyway. So we're walking back to the car. Uphill on the road, and it is steep all the way up through there. It's all uphill. Probably can't tell it on the camera, but this was part of the hike. At least
uphill.
At least we got to throw our packs down. Don't have to worry about that weight. This ain't part of the trail anyway. So I had to come back on and show this part. So until next time, this is Saline saying y'all stay salty.